Inside this gym, Becky Pomerleau pours her heart into all she does. Each push on the pedal, each step on the treadmill is a triumphant moment. Moments she and her family thought she might never experience again.
You can think that you're in such good health, but these types of things can really happen to anyone.
Just a few months earlier, while Becky and her husband Jeremiah were skiing in Breckenridge for their five-year anniversary, they came face to face with a moment that would forever change their lives.
As we were just dishing up lunch, I started having the chest pain and tingling down my left arm. And at that point, I thought, well, I personally couldn't really be having a heart attack, right? I'm so healthy.
Jeremiah quickly drove Becky to a nearby hospital.
As soon as I mentioned my wife experienced chest pains, literally a woman came out within 3 seconds, grabbed her, and took her to the back.
Doctors found that the inside layer of Becky's arteries had torn open, creating a blockage and a severe heart attack. She was suffering from spontaneous coronary artery dissection, or SCAD. Doctors told Jeremiah that in order for any chance of survival, they needed to send Becky by air to University of Colorado Hospital, the only hospital in the region with the expertise to help.
He was like, she has hours. We need to get her via flight.
Very few of the patients look like Becky coming in, you know, young, healthy patients.
We have all of the positives going for her. You see that she should be able to come through this. But quickly, we found out how sick her heart was.
What was really unusual is her heart was so dead that neither side moved hardly at all.
Doctors explained the severity of Becky's injuries.
I purely inquired, how likely is Becky going to make it through this procedure? And they said that your wife is an extremely sick girl, extremely sick, and we can only offer that we'll do our very best. And I was like, can you give me a percentage? He's like, it's very difficult for me to do so, but I can say 30%.
But Becky's story was far from over, and her setback was about to become the platform for her comeback.
These surgeons are at the top of their game. I've seen them work miracles with a lot of our patients, and this was a great example.
Against all odds, Becky made it through 5 surgeries in 2 days, and doctors implanted a temporary device to circulate her blood. Completely kept alive by machines and in dire need of a new heart, Becky was put at the top of the transplant list with nothing left to do but wait.
She had a finite amount of time. I mean, they had the assist devices in. They were at the last stage of being able to use those devices. She was not leaving the hospital until she got a transplant.
After 14 days of waiting and wondering if she'd get the heart she desperately needed, a doctor came into her room, locked eyes with Becky, and smiled.
And then I asked him, do we have a heart? And he said, yes, we have a heart.
Heart transplant, I think, is amazing because as soon as you get it plugged in, that heart starts beating. And I think it's completely humbling to us.
I believe it was Dr. Babu who came out and said that everything is great. The heart's ticking.
I don't think that any of us who've never been transplanted will truly fully get it. I've never had my life this close to being taken from me. So when it's given back to you in full, I can't imagine what that's like.
Not everybody takes it as a gift. And this is somebody that has nurtured this gift and will continue to give back.
The other thing that I do think about is the fact that another person had to perish in order for me to live. I do plan to write a letter to that family, thanking them for the gift that they've given me and letting them know the plans that I have to use this new chance at life. And then I would like to someday be able to meet that family and give them the opportunity, if they want, to listen to their daughter's heart still beating.